Yes, and emotional health. Now, you know, not all integrative doctors bring this element in, which is so critical. What do you find as far as the connection with that, people coming to you in late stage cancers and really an extreme degenerative state of health? Do you always find that there's a connection that maybe they haven't realized in their emotional life or in trauma or in grief or in loss or something like that?
The word you said, always, is definitely true. There's always a deep biological traumatic shock experience that was at the root cause of the presentation of the cancer. So we have a 6-page questionnaire that we have patients work on for about a week, and then we do a private session. And so the patients are forming their own timeline. What is the stuff? What, you know, what's the backpack? What's in the backpack of life that you're carrying? So was it that, you know, boyfriend in high school that dumped you for, you know, your best friend, right? Was it that abusive parent? Was it the sexual abuse? We're seeing this more and more, you know, how much sexual abuse is behind the scenes that to us it's kind of foreign, right? A lot of loss, you know, when someone has the loss of a loved one. Let me tell you a quick story. We had a patient here from Southern California that we have been treating for a number of years with ripe breast cancer. And Phyllis is her name. She was doing okay, you know, doing pretty well. And one day it occurred to me to approach her more in this topic of the emotional aspect of disease. And Phyllis ended up telling me that when she was 9 or 10 years of age, she was sexually abused by her father, her grandfather, and her uncle. So she was now in her early 60s, and so almost 50 years that those three people knew and she knew and kept that inside. Buried feelings never die, right? So now I was the fifth person to know. And I help her not only forgive and process, but really letting it go. Because the solution to the trauma, the conflict, is in the letting go. When Phyllis was able to let go, that tumor just regressed, and things are fine.
Absolutely amazing, that profound connection.
Yes.
And that is based on Hammer Medicine, correct?
That's based on Dr.
Reichard Hammer found that actually he had lost his own son and developed cancer and then became curious and studied and said, and he even has like particular issues connected with specific organs in the body. And it's quite amazing, but totally on target according to your work because you see that it confirms every time. So it's in talking and the bringing this to the awareness of the person and then having them forgive and release where you start to see major healing.
And as a scientist, as a medical doctor, this was hard for me to really grasp, right? So I had an experience that maybe I could share here.
Yes.
I was taking a workshop in this Hammer Medicine, the work of Dr. Sabath and others, throughout the years that I've really looked at, you know, the biological conflict and disease. And so the doctor who was giving this workshop asked me, Dr. Tony, tell me about your mom, just out of the blue. It was a small group of maybe 25 of us. So I told him about my mother, who ever since I left home to go to college, she would require me to call her every day. And the day that I didn't call her, even when I was in med school, she would say, oh, son, don't you love me anymore? How could you do this to me? I worry so much about you. And, you know, just like the guilt trip. And it was like, oh, a very difficult call. So I'm telling this to the doctor who's giving the workshop. And my big toe starts to throb and hurt.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
So it's a long story. But what happened is the next day, I had a rough night that evening. The next day, I go back to the workshop, and he says, did anyone experience anything in the evening? So I raise my hand, and I tell him about my big toe. So being a French-Canadian, he's like, bravo, bravo. And then he says, open your workbook on page 17 and look at the conflict related with the big toe. So I open the workbook, conflict related to the mother, with obligation to do as the mother asked for.
Wow, It couldn't be more pinpointed. That is incredible.
And guess what? So he helped me let this go. I never told my mom this story. And after that, my mom has never said that again.
Absolutely.
I don't understand at all.
Incredible.
But I've witnessed it personally in dozens and dozens of patients. So please, for those of you who are watching this, it's very, very important to address the emotional aspect of disease and wellness, and what are those traumas and conflict behind your cancer.